Hey y'all, and welcome to Spare Room. I'm Karen Terry, and today we're going to talk about tips for shy role players. When I say shy, I want to be clear. I'm talking about people who don't reach out or speak up or participate out of some kind of fear, where in normal circumstances, they would do all of these things. What I'm not talking about is someone who's introverted. So that's someone who doesn't reach out or participate or speak up, but they're still perfectly happy and having fun. So in this video, I'm addressing shy role players, not introverted role players. So a lot of the stuff on my channel, I already assume I'm talking to people who are shy with their role play. Why? Because it's incredibly common. I rarely encounter a role player who is perfectly extroverted or completely carefree or totally fine with all of that stuff and they don't have any insecurities. We all come into this hobby with our own past and our own baggage. So what do we do about it? My first tip, if you're a shy role player, is to do a little bit of self-assessment and try to figure out where exactly that shyness is coming from, because that's going to help you figure out what you need to do. Now, before we get into some of the practical tips, I want to address something first. If you are suffering from serious anxiety, depression, or other similar mental illnesses, seek help. Your roleplay partners are not equipped to help you with your mental illness, no matter how much they might really want to. To help with that, you need a network of people in your real life, and that network should probably include a therapist or a counselor that knows professionally how to help you with these things. So, what if you're struggling with shyness, but it's not clinical or anything like that? What do you do? If your shyness is coming from a fear of rejection, you need to learn how to accept that rejection and move on, because rejection will happen. You can't prevent it. The best thing you can do in this situation is to keep trying. Keep trying to attract the right kind of roleplay partner. Keep trying to better yourself so that you're the best roleplay partner you can be. And whatever you do, if this is you, don't sit and wait for people to come to you. If you think this will work, it won't. And the reason why is because a lot of people think this will work, and they're all just sitting and waiting for someone to contact them. Now, the good news is, when you start reaching out to role players, each time you do it, it becomes a little bit easier. So I have a lot of videos on my channel that address these types of things, not specifically around the fear of rejection, but it's woven into a ton of my videos. So I recommend going through and looking at my catalog and watching as many of those videos as you can so that you can better yourself, so that you can handle that rejection better. What if your shyness comes from being new to roleplay? You don't really know how to go about it or what kind of character you want to make. What I recommend in that case is joining a group and making a very specialized character. That way, you're only really focusing on a narrow topic and you don't feel like then you have to learn everything all at once. So for this type of character, first think of the goal that character has and center everything around that one singular goal. This will help you know exactly where your character should be jumping in on the plot and make it easy for you to not jump in on every single plot and event that's going on without disrupting the rhythm of the roleplay. It can be tempting if you're going to do this to say, oh, well, I'm shy, so I'm going to make a really shy character and center everything around that. I wouldn't recommend this. The reason why is shy characters are inherently difficult to get to jump into the action. So if the main thing about your character is that they're shy, what can happen is then you don't really know exactly where your character should jump in, and you're constantly saying, well, I don't want them to jump in there because they're shy, and that ends up becoming a reason to not jump into anything, and it reinforces that out-of-character shyness that you're already experiencing. So if you're shy yourself, no shy characters. What if your shyness comes from you not wanting to feel exposed? You're just here to roleplay. You're not here to make friends. You're not concerned about the social aspect of roleplay. You just want to write. This can be successful, but I think that you'll be more successful if you make yourself just a little bit vulnerable. Your connection with your partners and with their characters can be so much deeper if you have that good out-of-character communication and friendship. Now, I'm not saying you need to talk every day and be bestest best buddy friends with your partner. What I'm saying is get to know them slowly. And the only way that you can really get to know someone else slowly is if they are revealing parts of themselves and you are also revealing parts of yourself in that process. It may feel awkward at first, but in general, people like you better when they know you're not perfect. What if your shyness comes from thinking that you're going to embarrass yourself or damage your reputation? There's a relatively simple solution in regards to this, and that is, remember, it's the internet. So at any time, you can start a new account with a new name, with new partners on a new platform where no one knows you. And if you're role-playing with a bunch of strangers on a new platform with no history or obligation, who cares if you embarrass yourself? If you're like this, but you're not playing with strangers, think really hard about the people that you're role-playing with. These people are probably on some level your friends, and they care about you, and they're not going to care if you make mistakes. What they're going to care about is how you react when mistakes are pointed out. So, how should you react? If necessary, apologize. Apologizing isn't always going to be necessary in these situations, but something that is necessary is making sure that whatever the behavior was, that you don't do it again. Remember, mistakes happen to everyone. There's no such thing as a role player that doesn't make mistakes. Maybe you have character consistency issues, or maybe you have plot holes in your stories, or maybe you upset people out of character sometimes. It's okay. We all do these things. In general, it's helpful to remember that at the end of the day, we're all just playing pretend on the internet. None of this matters more than you let it matter. This is a hobby that we're doing for fun. It doesn't define you as a person or validate your existence. So those are my tips for shy role players. Let me know down below if any of this feels like you and if those are the types of things that you've done to try to overcome that shyness with role playing. And remember to like if you like this video, comment down below with any questions that you have, subscribe for more videos, click that bell for notifications, all the links to my social media down in the doobly-doo. Thank you so much for watching and make it a great day.